Good evening. My name is Regan Guzik, and this project consisted of choosing a charity that was best for Professor Jameson to donate her time and funds to. After hard thought and thorough research, our group decided to choose a local organization titled the Silver Lining Cancer Fund, or the SLCF for short, as you will hear us refer it to. So, to begin our presentation, I would like to discuss the history and background of the organization. First, what is the Silver Lining Cancer Fund? The SLCF is a nonprofit organization that is comprised of a group of healthcare professionals and volunteers that basically help meet the needs of people diagnosed with cancer in the Tri-County region. And those counties include Columbiana, Mahoning, and Trumbull. It was started in 1975 by Dr. Lawrence Pass, a local hematologist and oncologist who worked with the Youngstown Hospital Association, and he was also joined with a group of volunteers. The group recognized that many cancer patients were unable to receive the care they needed due to lack of money. So, for example, they couldn't buy food, they couldn't buy the medications needed to reduce the side effects from their treatments, or they didn't have enough funds to transportation to the clinic. So how does the SLCF help? They provide patients that are undergoing active treatment for malignant diseases with financial assistance. So the patients must be in financial need, and that's decided by a board of trustees of the organization. And they provide up to $150 a month per person to cover certain areas of need for those patients. So in conclusion, there is a silver lining even when bad things happen, hence the Silver Lining Cancer Fund. For over 30 years, this organization has been able to provide families with financial assistance that ease the burden and help make the difficult process just a bit easier. And now we will transition over to Stephen, who will discuss the legitimacy of the organization.
The Silver Lining Cancer Fund Incorporated is an incredible charity. This organization has 30-year history of serving the Tri-County area and is a 501c3 organization. This status means the IRS allows federal tax exemption of nonprofit organization and is regulated and administrated by the U.S. Department of Treasury. To receive the 501c3 status, the charity has to apply to the IRS for recognition by filing Form 1023, which is an application for recognizing a tax exception. This charity must also file an IRS Form 990 every year, which ensures that the organization is compliance with the governance structure, procedures, and activities. These IRS filing proof of the organization is not a scam, since it is controlled by federal government. How the organization determines the distribution of funds is also regulated. Every dollar from this fund goes to patients who are currently having cancer treatment and need help with daily living expenses, such as medication costs, household expenses, utilities, food, and transportation to medical centers. A cancer patient must apply for patient assistance to prove they are in financial need. Therefore, the patient assistance application contains certain guidelines. The patient must have documented proof of cancer diagnosis and currently receiving treatment. The person must live in Trumbull, Mahoning, Columbia, Mercer, or Lawrence County. The patient must provide the employer's name, physician name, treatment facility, cancer diagnosis, and number of dependents and household income information, such as salary, income from spouse, or any other source of income must be included. Allowable expenses that can be reported are mortgage or rent payments, cost of food, utilities, insurance, premiums, and property taxes. After the application is completed, if it is submitted to the Silver Lining Fund, the Board of Trustees reviews the application to determine if the patient qualifies for financial assistance. If the patient qualifies, the Board of Trustees will determine the amount of disbursement of funds, which is usually in increments of $150 per month. this financial assistance can last up to 1 year or until other financial help becomes available. Justification for Professor Jameson of why she should consider this cause. Michaela?
As you know, the Silver Lining Cancer Fund assists current cancer patients going through treatment who are in serious financial need. Expenses cancer patients may have to pay for are doctor visits, lab tests such as blood tests, procedures and surgeries, imaging tests such as CT scans or MRIs, radiation and chemotherapy treatments, drug costs such as prescription medication, hospital stays, and home care. If a patient requires home care, expenses such as equipment and nurses can be very costly. These expenses can cost patients anywhere from $10,000 to over $100,000 a year, and most insurance plans do not cover the entire cost. While undergoing treatment, patients are not able to work, therefore a lot of patients do not have any type of income for a temporary period of time to pay for any of the costs that their insurance does not cover. A great reason why Professor Jameson should donate to the Silver Lining Cancer Fund is because if the charity does not raise enough money to supply every cancer patient with the assistance they need, that patient may not be able to afford the treatment they need. Now we go to Andrea for stories and statistics.
The Silver Lining Cancer Fund is a really great foundation that donates up to $150 per month per person that it helps, which it has totaled to $60,000 just this year. So a couple stories online that were like testimonies as to why this fund is such a great help to the community, they range from all different people. So one of the stories was from a 20-year-old who was in remission, and they hope of going back to college to actually get their master's degree. So without this foundation, they wouldn't be able to be in remission and have the finances to even go back to school, go back to college. So this just shows how the fund is helping people to pursue their dreams. Another story was about a guy named Steve, who his wife actually had cancer for 15 years. And this fund helped pay for her insurance to like to keep the medicine going and to keep her from to get into remission and actually recover from cancer. So this just shows how the fund is keeping a brighter future for the people to have families together. The last story is about a girl named Jessica, and it really stuck out to me in the sense that she was 24 years old and actually died from cancer, but her friends wanted to continue her story and wanted to keep the attention of cancer and wanting to help people out, so they actually raised $2,300 and donated it to the fund, the Silver Lining Cancer Fund, which is the same fund that actually helped Jessica when she was like getting treatment, and Jessica's mom, who also had cancer. So that just shows how this community helps bring people together to help everyone out. And it does not only affect the person that it's giving the treatment to, but also the people around them. So now to Eric with why and how Professor Jameson should donate to this charity.
So you may be asking yourself, why this fund? Why Silver Linings Cancer Fund and not American Cancer Society or a huge corporation out there? Well, that is the answer. They are the huge corporations that they're not going to really focus on the Mahoning, Trumbull, Columbiana area. They're going to focus on the world at large. This area too, but definitely they have much more of a larger range. This area is the sole purpose of Silver Linings Cancer Fund. And that's it. They're $150 a month to accepted applicants who are in need of assistance outside of their medical. And you really need anything you could get during this time. Whether $150 could go cover any utility bill or just essential things you need to have during this time that's not medical. Because even in medical, kind of similar to the dilemma that comes in with the corporation, it's not going to make a whole big, it's not going to make much of a dent into it. So, that's kind of the same philosophy, I suppose. But yeah, like I said, they're going to help with bills and improve their these patients' quality of life. If you wish to donate to this, you would go to their website at silverliningsfund.org. There's a donate tab where they accept a variety of credit cards, other payment options like PayPal. If you wish to donate via like a web form, like a form mail-in thing, there's a form you can download on that same site. Print it out, you know, mail it. And you would mail it to P.O. Box 401, Campfield, Ohio, 44406. But volunteering is more your route. They also present a variety of different options, of which they have one huge event every year, one major fundraiser. That goes along with the individual and corporate donations they get. And you could be involved in event planning for that. There's a lot of phones to manage, so you could be doing that. Or you could be involved in just client interaction, making sure the fund is working for them. You know, no problems between getting the funds and whatnot. And if you have any suggestions for Silver Linings Cancer Fund, they're willing to listen to all of your suggestions and ideas. Just call them up on their number 330-702-0550. It's a very low overhead cost, so nearly all of this money is going into right into the patient's pocket. That overhead's just to cover basic office fees. And you could donate whatever you want, several incremental periods at work. And this is really how Dr. Pass's work lives on. People like Andrea mentioned, they're getting genuine help through this organization. And I'm going to send it over to Trenton now to wrap things up.
All right, the difference between Silver Lining Cancer Fund and other funds is that first, it supports the need of any cancer patient in the Tri-County area. Whereas other large organizations such as St. Jude and American Cancer Society help patients nationwide, and that is a substantial number to accommodate. The benefit to Silver Lining is that because their focus is in the Tri-County area, their chances and opportunities to help more individuals with cancer greatly increases. This, in turn, is a big difference that some people may overlook, and the more individuals helped, the better the success. Another thing that makes Silver Lining different is they have only one major fundraising event each year to get as much support as they can and to spread the word about their cancer fund. Otherwise, Silver Lining relies on the donations and the volunteers from individuals as well as corporate businesses. This reason definitely makes it a big difference in that Silver Lining has just one opportunity a year to put the word out about their cancer fund and get as much donations as possible. Whereas these other cancer funds have TV commercials and multiple fundraising events each year and provides more awareness for people to recognize and give back. This makes it critical for Silver Lining, who does not have these resources just yet, to get as much help and support to spread the word about a local cancer research fund. Another point of emphasis to point out is that all donations raised, as well as anything else that may be given to the Silver Lining Cancer Fund, stays in the Tri-County region to support the needs of cancer patients. This is a good thing to consider when trying to decide if someone would want to give to this fund, knowing where your money is going, that it is going to stay local. These are some of the major differences that separate Silver Lining Cancer Fund from the other cancer funds around the country. I personally did not ever hear about Silver Lining Cancer Fund until now, before I could imagine that other people have not heard of it either.
And if we were to make the individuals more aware of these differences, it could open eyes and save more lives. And to sum up, everything that has been talked about through each individual in this presentation provides good reasons and good details as to why Professor Jameson should